Já znám poměrně velkou skupinu lidí, kteří neúplně otevřeně chtějí mluvit o své práci. Ale to, že tenhle kanál roste, že ho neustále odebírá čím dál tím víc a víc lidí, je občas dokáže přesvědčit k tomu, aby o své práci nám pověděli něco víc. A právě o tom bude dnešní video. Než se k tomhle videu dostaneme, tak ještě bych chtěl říct dvě věci. První věc je, že ještě budeme o 3 dny prodlužovat dobu, kdy si můžete objednat merch, takže pokud se vám ta tvorba líbí, tak jim tímto stylem můžete podpořit. Druhá věc je, že mám možnost natočit rozhovor s herečkou filmu pro dospělé. Je to poměrně známá americká herečka, chcete-li to takhle nazvat, ale já nevím, jestli byste o to měli zájem. Tak mi napište dolů do komentářů. Pokud ne, tak já bych to natočil stejně a vydám to jenom jako bonusový díl pro lidi na Patreon. Takže to minimálně alespoň někdo uvidí, protože si myslím, že by to zajímavé bylo. Takže dejte mi vědět, co si o tom myslíte a užijte si dnešní video.
Okay guys, so today I'm here with my friend Harley.
Hello.
And she is gonna shortly introduce herself because I think I wouldn't be able to make a perfect introduction.
My name is Harley and I live in Los Angeles and I'm a burlesque dancer. And I used to be a stripper as well. They kind of go hand in hand, but as of right now, I'm just mainly a burlesque dancer and I do burlesque shows. I have my own burlesque troupe and I'm more of like a rock and roll metal vibe. So
yeah, as you can see.
I do. Yeah.
As you can see.
Yes, it's more of rock and roll.
So can you describe the difference between stripping and the burlesque?
Yes. So burlesque is more art of the tease.
Okay.
So burlesque is like da-na-na-na-na and it's the tease that draws you in and it's more theatrical, whereas stripping is more just like
nudity.
Well, yeah, but it's just more of like
here you are.
Just taking clothes off and not really having any meaning to it.
Okay. Well,
yeah.
You don't really like get a lot of people talking about this openly. So I would like to thank you for doing that.
Of course, okay? Yeah.
And let's just dive straight into the fact that you had to decide to do it somehow. So what was the way? So how it all started?
It's kind of a funny story. So first I was a regular, like just a jazz dancer because there's different types of dance. So I went to high school and I did the whole thing. We were on the dance team and like all that stuff. And I just love dance. It's a great, you know, I just love it. It's a big part of my life. And then I moved out to LA and I went to college for dance, got my dance teaching certificate, choreographic studies. So that was more of like artsy dancing, right? And then I randomly was looking to get into burlesque. I don't know how that popped in my head. It was probably the movie Burlesque with Cher and Christina Aguilera. Okay, so I think that kind of helped me, that inspired me to look into it in the LA scene. And so I sent a couple emails out and it just so happens one of these troupes, they were having an audition soon. So I went to the audition. I was very late, and I remember I wore the skimpiest outfit compared to everyone else, and because I didn't know what to wear. I don't know anything about burlesque, so, but I made it, and then I started burlesque dancing, and I did that for about 2 years, and then I realized with my style, no one wanted to hire me because it was too rock and roll, too crazy, too risque, so I decided to form my own burlesque troupe, which is called the Damned Devils, and they're more of what I am, pretty much. So I started that. And then I was working a 9-to-5 job, trying to manage producing my own shows and being at other people's shows as well. And I remember going into my boss, like into her office, and I said, you know what? I'm gonna quit and become a stripper. And she was like, what? And I was like, yeah, I wanted to move to Vegas. I was like, I'm gonna move to Vegas and I'm gonna go strip.
Okay.
And so, yeah, I put in my 2 weeks notice and I ended up not moving because I thought about it and I realized that my home, my heart's in LA and I really don't want to go to Vegas.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I'm glad I didn't because I'd be eaten alive. but so I stayed in LA and I found a local strip club and I was, and it was called Burlesque.
Oh.
So I thought, I thought it was a burlesque spot. And I showed up there with pasties on, and they're like, "Oh no, no!
You have to
take those off." So I'm in the bathroom, like ripping off, you know.
And they're like, "Oh, this is just waste of clothes."
Yeah. So then I auditioned, and I made it, and I've been stripped there for about 3 years, I'd say.
Wow. So you've been doing stripping for 3 years.
Yes.
So how big is the stripping scene in LA?
It's pretty big. It's actually dwindling down right now because of the new laws and stuff. But It's pretty big.
So which cities are the most popular for stripping? Because I'm not sure like if in Beverly Hills we can find a strip
No.
course. So there's definitely some cities.
Yeah, it's mainly in the areas like Van Nuys, North Hollywood, uh-huh. and downtown
okay.
LA. Yeah.
Which of those are your most popular?
Probably the ones in Van Nuys. Okay. Oh, you mean like what clubs?
Yeah.
Depends. Do you want topless? Do you want full nude? Or do you want a bikini bar? Because we have bikini bars.
We are going to get into those in mm-hmm. the second video that we are going to film. Because this is just crazy.
It's
how many rules
crazy.
And like stuff you have to deal with on daily basis to do this job, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So, but in this video, I want to talk more about you, you know? So
okay.
Is there like anything you prefer? Let's say if you get some work from some certain club and you're like, yes, I want to work there. Instead of if you get a work from some other club, you are like not as excited.
Yeah, so there's some good clubs and some bad clubs. Yeah, with my style, let's see here.
Because that's going to be good information for people
yeah.
when they can go visit. You know?
I don't want to say anything bad. But I don't want to work for the clubs that uh-huh. are
yeah, you don't have to name them.
Shady.
Oh.
You know, and a little bit like very illegal.
Very illegal.
I don't want to work at those places. And I'm not going to say what they are, but
yeah,
I don't
want to
work at those places. So okay. I only work at the places that I feel comfortable in and that I know I won't get in trouble mm-hmm. type of thing.
Okay.
Like
okay.
They know what they're doing type of
so
thing.
So I'm sure that stripping is not something that your family wants to see you doing,
no,
right?
No.
So can you tell us a little bit of what was the reaction when they find out?
So my family knows I'm a burlesque dancer and they always knew about that. Uh-huh. And sorry, my cats. they always knew about that. And I've only one person in my family, one of my aunts, have seen me do burlesque.
Mm-hmm.
One. And I was on tour and I happened to be in our state and I was doing burlesque shows for the military.
Mm-hmm.
And we were doing like, we put on these burlesque shows for veterans and whatnot, like at restaurants or bars where we're at. And whatever the money we make on those shows, then we do G-rated shows like doo-wop, doo-wop, doo-wop for the military in like VA hospitals and homes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So anyway. That was a tangent. Anyway, so she saw me in another state. I think it was Oklahoma. She saw me, and that was the first one in my family to see me do burlesque. And she was a little bit like, woo, you know, woo, what are you doing, you know? And my family knows I do it. They see what I post online.
Mm-hmm.
I never came out and said that I've done stripping, mm-hmm. but I think they'll know.
Yeah,
it's just one of those things.
They
just know, and they just... whatever, you know, like,
well, just for me, when I was watching the stuff that you post online, they must know.
They gotta know. They gotta know.
I mean, I knew.
They gotta know. And it's just like one of those things, like, we don't talk about it. Like,
uh-huh.
we know it happens and we just don't talk about it. If they ever asked me, mm-hmm. I would be honest. I'd be like, yeah,
of course.
Because I'm proud of what I do.
Mm-hmm.
And I really like the fact that stripping gave me a really good foundation in terms of the dance world and like being a sexier dancer.
Uh-huh.
I learned so much, just like how to interact with people,
mm-hmm.
how to hustle, you know, like,
yeah, yeah.
And just like for me as a performer. So, I mean, I really don't do it so much anymore because you grow out of it, it's a phase and you kind of just like meh. But it just really made me a better entertainer. So if anyone's considering it, I highly recommend it.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, if you're one of those people that can't stay away from drugs or if you're then no, don't get in that industry.
Uh-huh.
But for me, I'm not really into that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So it's more of a performance aspect.
So you go in and then you go out.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
I'm not like...
Until like what age? Let's talk just stripping mainly.
Okay,
okay. Look, until what age are you able to do such a job in a city like LA?
So some clubs will have an age limit.
Mm-hmm.
So if you go and apply and they don't tell you.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Yeah,
they will just pick you up.
Well, they'll give other reasons or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But pretty much most of the time they have an age limit. And I can't remember what my age limit is for the club that I used to work at. But I want to say, I don't want to say, because it depends on how you look.
Mm-hmm.
If you're in your 40s,
oh, yeah.
but you look amazing
mm-hmm.
and you're all like done up, you know, you can work. But if, yeah, you know what I mean? Like, yeah. But like if you're in your 40s and it looks like you're in your 40s, you're probably not going to get hired. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So the only people that are in a club that are older and you can tell they're older, it's probably because they're grandfathered in, meaning they started in their 20s and they're still there. So that's the only reason why they're still at the club.
So did you do the stripping because you were thinking, okay, it's just something temporary, or you just were going there just straight for the money, or you like it at the time, or like combination of all of those?
So for me, because I went into stripping because I wanted something different in my life, and I wanted to perform more. And I thought about long and hard about it because like I was just like, I know people are gonna judge me from here on out. They're gonna say, oh, you know, you're just a stripper, you're just whatever, and they're gonna treat me like dirt. So I knew that was gonna happen. Thankfully it doesn't. But in my mind I was preparing myself for that. And I was like, okay, so what are the benefits of me leaving my 9-to-5 job to go to this? And I was really depressed in my 9-to-5. I don't do well in offices, you know. And I'm a dancer, I'm a natural performer. So I decided, I don't know, fuck everything, and I'm gonna go do it. And so it wasn't meant to be permanent. No, not at all. It was temporary. But it was more for me to find myself and kind of figure out what I want to do with my life.
So compared to stripping and regular dancing, how hard in LA is to get a job as a dancer versus a stripper?
So if you're just a regular dancer, not even a burlesque dancer, but like a jazz dancer, hip hop performer, you have to have an agency because it's very hard to get booked on jobs as a dancer. You make no money. And I think I need to really say that. You make no money as a dancer. Like, people just need to know that. Stripping, you do make more money, but...
Because you make tips, right?
Right. And that's a different... It's more than just dancing. I'm also a psychiatrist. You know what I'm saying? Like,
look at some session, guys.
So there's more to it than just dancing. Whereas when you're just a dancer performing, it's like, I don't know. There's no money. So in order to make money and to get like in the background gigs, like Beyonce or whatever, and
you have to be that, either famous
need to have an agency and you need to be a damn good dancer. Like, you need to be like amazing. It's like when people think they're gonna make, what's it called, NBA, the basketball stuff. It's like when they're in high school and they think they're gonna make that shit. You need a little bit more than just like being the best in your school. So it's kind of like that with LA, I feel like, with the dancing world. And a lot of people do have agencies, but they don't have work. And that's what it is, because you go to audition.
And they don't pick you.
Well, it's just they pick what they want. So you can't tell how much money you're going to make if you're going to make anything. I know of a lot of dancers that are homeless and that live in their cars and stuff like that because they want to be a dancer so bad, but it's just so difficult.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. So, they cannot, like, support the life by themselves if they have just dancing job.
Right.
If you mention, like, if you are not that good that you can dance for Beyonce, then you live in your car.
Right.
You know, and then you are living the LA dream. But that's how it is.
So
how many years in total have you been doing either burlesque or stripping in LA? Like, in total, 6 years?
Fuck. I don't know.
At least six years ago. And I think you've been doing that.
I think it's at least six.
Yeah? Okay. So because I met you 6 years ago, and I think, like, you've been already doing that, right?
Yes, we met like a long time ago. My gosh. I think
it's quite a journey. Okay, guys, and
it's
now
crazy.
That's gonna be it for this part, for the introduction and kind of the general information. And now in next video we're gonna talk more about this journey, some experiences, some of the laws, and just a lot of crazy stuff. So if you wanna see a chapter number 2, don't forget to subscribe, hit a like on this video, and the next video is going to be out soon.
Yes.
Thank you for this.
Of course, thank you.
And we're going to soon continue. See you next time. Would you work in South Central or Compton?
No.
Why?
I would be eaten alive.
Do you think that some of those clubs can work as upfronts?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. That's super common. I mean, I don't know what clubs, but
yeah.
Come on. Yeah.